All right, guys, so in this video, we're going to talk about something that's super cool about NMAP, if you haven't used it before, and that's the operating system fingerprinting, or OS detection. Absolutely, if you're studying for a cybersecurity certification, you got to know how this works. Now, it almost seems like magic. We can just run a scan and find out what kind of operating system is on the target. Now, why is that useful? Well, if we're going to find a vulnerability that we can use to compromise that device or machine, then we got to know what kind of operating system is running. So in this video, we're going to talk about how this type of scan works and how we can interpret it with NMAP. So stick around. All right, so NMAP, operating system fingerprinting. I get super nerdy about this. I think it's the coolest feature, something that's super fun to look at and learn how it works. So on my Kali Linux tool, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna run two different operating system tests. One is gonna be toward a Linux server, and the other is going to be toward a Windows machine. Now I know these operating systems, but I wanna see, is NMAP able to accurately fingerprint them? So let's find out. Here, if we take a look at our command line, so we're gonna come over there. Now, if we're gonna run the operating system fingerprint, this is a privileged thing. So we do have to do sudo first. Okay, now before I run my test, I'm first gonna come over to my command line, and this time I'm gonna capture this trace file and make sure that I share this with you guys. So let's go ahead and write this out. Just gonna say dumpcap, gonna give it the interface, and there I'm gonna give it the name of the capture file. And I added dash S so I know that this is the server that I'm fingerprinting. So I'm gonna go ahead and get that running on the background, and you're gonna start to see packets come in as the NMAP test begins to run. So let's go ahead and go over to our other command line and let's go ahead and hit enter. So this test can take a few seconds to run. Under the hood, we're not just running a TCP scan, but we're also doing some extra stuff with UDP, also ICMP probes. So we're gonna go ahead and see how that looks on the wire. Now here we can see with the results right here, we were able to identify this operating system. Here we've got a Linux and we got a version there. So that gives us some of those OS details. Now before I do anything else, I'm gonna come over here and just stop that PCAP. All right, so we were able to scan the server. Now let's go ahead and scan Windows. All right, so I'm gonna come over here and I'm just gonna run another PCAP. Well, this time I'm gonna do dash client, or this time I'm gonna do dash W. So that's for Windows. Okay, so just gonna get that to run and then come back over to my command line prompt. I'm going to go ahead and hit that Windows box. All right, so now that that test is finished, I'm gonna stop that capture. Now, if we come back over here, we can see that the test was successful. We were able to identify that this is Microsoft Windows 10. Okay, so we have those two PCAPs. I went ahead and included those in the description down below so you can download them and follow right along if you'd prefer. I'm gonna go ahead and start with the Windows 10 PCAP. So let's go ahead and open that up in Wireshark. Okay, so in OS fingerprinting, basically what NMAP is doing is looking at these little values that come back from an operating system stack to try to determine what OS it is. All right, so all OSs have slightly different behaviors in the way that they respond. So things like IPTTL, starting sequence number in TCP, or even the way that they respond to a null or a Christmas scan or other strange flags that we throw at it, that can help us to determine the type of operating system. So to help us learn that, let's go ahead and go to our display filter up here. Let's set a filter for port 135. Everybody remember how to do that? TCP port 135. So let's do tcp.port and we're gonna do equals equals 135. Okay, so we're gonna focus on this port because that's one of the ports that was open. Once the OS fingerprinting scan finds an open port, it starts to poke at it a little bit more to try to further determine what type of operating system it is. Okay, so here we can see that there's several different SYNs that went toward this OS. Now the first one, let's just take a look at this. In fact, let's just focus on only the SYNs. Let's see what was different about each one of these probes that we sent to this operating system. All right, so what I wanna do is I only wanna focus on TCP SYNs. There's a handful of ways that we can filter on only SYNs. Here's one of them. If we come over here, we're just gonna do and we're gonna do tcp.flags equals equals 0x, so hexadecimal 002. Okay, and that will filter on only the flags that go out. And you might be thinking, Chris, how did you remember 002? Well, basically, if you select a SYN and you come down to TCP, open that up, go down to flags, you see flag 002. So I don't want just all packets with SYN, I want the ones with SYN and not ACK. If I said tcp.flags.syn equals one, well, that would show me the SYNs and the SYN ACKs. I don't want that, I just want these SYNs. So here I can see I've got seven packets that were sent to this open port. and notice that most of them were 100 milliseconds apart. That's also a part of the test, but more on that maybe on another video. Okay, so let's take a look at this first sin. You notice up here in the information, I'm just gonna blow this up a little bit for you guys. All right, just reorient myself here. All right, so let's go ahead and see what was different about all these sins. Now the first one, this was basically just the stealth scan probe. It was just us knocking on the door and just finding out, is anybody home? Okay, so here we found that there was a response to the sin. If I filtered on this, I'd see a SYNAC. But after that, what happens about a second and a half later, I start to probe with a bit more detail here. So if I come to the second packet, you can join me on packet 2107. Let's see what was different about this packet. See, on that first one, I just have an MSS of 1460, window size of 1024. But check this out, packet 2107. Here already I start to see some interesting things. All right, my time to live is 43. That's kind of random, right? So I'm sending this out, right? In a normal system, my outgoing TTL is going to be a full count TTL, and it certainly won't be different like it was in the first packet, okay? That was 37 in the first packet. If I come to the TCP stuff, let's go ahead and open up that part of the header. If I come down here, let's see what we find here. So first of all, I'm sending in the SYN, I'm sending an acknowledgement number. Okay, so my sequence number is here. My acknowledgement number is this 345-959-256. Okay, that's super weird. First of all, I don't have an ACK flag at all. So I'm not even indicating that I'm using this ACK number. But really, this is strange that I even have it here. In fact, even Wireshark's kind of weirded out by it. It's like, hey, wait a second, this acknowledgement number field is non-zero. So what's this all about? That's kind of weird. Well, really, what I'm interested in is how does this device respond when I throw it a weird ACK number? Also, window size, check that out, 1, okay? If I come down here to options, I'm sending 20 bytes of options, sending a pretty large window scale, my maximum segment size, 1460, I'm sending timestamps, I'm sending SAC permitted. Okay, so my goal here is to see how does this device respond. Now, each SYN is gonna be slightly different in its behavior. In fact, check this out. Just look at the different window sizes that I'm sending, 63, 4, 4, 16, 5, 12. If I come over here to my options, I send different MSS sizes, a SAC permitted. Okay, so the question is, how does the device respond to all these? Well, let's go ahead and add our SYNAX. So now for this, I'm just gonna say tcp.flags. Now I wanna see what those responses are. So, oops. Let's go to SYN, and we're gonna do equals equals 1. All right. Okay, now in these responses, every little value that that operating system comes back with matters to me from top to bottom because this is how I can fingerprint that operating system. All right, so let me go up and start with our IP. I'm gonna go ahead and go to packet 2108. You can join me there. All right, so first of all, he's coming back. He's saying don't fragment. His TTL is 128. If I come down to TCP, how does he respond? Well, he's starting with this level of, or this range of sequence number. You see that raw number there? That's something that I'm gonna note. The acknowledgement number, he should do plus one on the sequence number that I sent him. But really the window size, so the starting window size is gonna be interesting to me. Okay, then I come down here to the options. Okay, so the MSS size is gonna be something interesting to me. The window scale that he uses, the SAC permitted, do we have select acknowledgement or not? And also notice what's not here. See, when I sent the SYN over there, I asked, hey, do you wanna do timestamps? And in 2108, we see that come back and there was not a timestamp option. Okay, so all of these things are things I'm gonna note. How did he respond to that value? How did he respond to this or that? Or what was these little things that he comes back with, all these little values, and then those values are compared against an operating system database that NMAP has. Now I'm gonna show you this. Now this is not light reading. In fact, I went ahead and linked it down below in the description. You can go down there and hit it if you'd like to. I'm gonna show you what that looks like. So let me bring in this operating system database. So right here, I went down to the Microsoft Windows area of this very, very large file, and you can see all the different types of operating systems that NMAP is able to enumerate or to identify. So again, what it does is it takes those responses that it gets from all of those different types of probes, and not just TCP 135, but it's also doing probes with UDP, with ICMP echoes, we're checking out a lot of things and determining how this operating system is responding. Now, it takes those responses and it compares them against all these results. Now, I told you that this wasn't light reading. This is very detailed, complex stuff that NMAP is looking at here, very subtle things that it's watching for in order to identify an operating system. Now, if you want the gory details, I went ahead and linked in the description down below. Here we can see the TCP/IP fingerprinting methods. This is out on NMAP and it shows all the messy details of the different values that it goes to try to figure out what an operating system is. So if you ever have insomnia and you can't sleep, definitely recommend you read that. But let's go ahead and go back to our PCAP and take a look at a few other things. Okay, so another thing that NMAP's gonna do, let's go ahead and take a look at ICMP. All right, so it also sends a few different ICMP requests. Now, if you take a look at that first one, check this out. Now, if we expand or if we minimize IP, here we can see IP, it's saying don't fragment. Okay, it's throwing that at it. But here, this is yellow. Let's go ahead and see why it's yellow. Well, it says no response seen. That's interesting because the packet below in packet 2126 is a ping reply. But let's take a look at why. You notice that this is ICMP type 8, code 9. Okay, CCNA, what is ICMP type 8, code 9? Now, I don't know if you remember that one on your test or if you haven't had that test in a while, but basically the network is administratively prohibited. We can't get there. But an unusual one that we would see. So part of this probe is to see how does this device respond to it? Do we get a normal ping reply or do we see a different type of code that we should see coming back? But our point here is we want to see how does that operating system reply. If we keep going, take a look at the next request. Here, this is just a typical ping. This is an ICMP echo request with a code 0. If I come up here to our IP header values, this time we're not setting any flags. Our time to live, 54. So again, we start adjusting some of these values and we are interested in every single bit and byte that comes back from that operating system to try to fingerprint it. Now, we're not gonna get these kind of results in every single case. Sometimes we're gonna get an inconclusive response from NMAP. Despite all these tests and probes, it's gonna do its best to try to fingerprint, but it won't be able to definitively determine which operating system it was. And this is because operating systems change, stacks get adjusted, or maybe it just wasn't able to get enough feedback on these different open ports to make that determination. But we can see how much is actually going on under the hood when it does have an open port. Lots of different probes and different protocols to try to determine that operating system. All right, so I hope that this video helped you understand a little further how NMAP does OS fingerprinting. Now, there's a whole lot more that we can say about this. Definitely invite you to check out that NMAP link that I have in the description down below with all the gory details. Go ahead and download that fingerprinting database from NMAP. And of course, stay tuned on the channel as we go deeper and deeper into how these NMAP scans work. So thanks for stopping by, and I'll see you guys on another video.